Hi, I'm Rom. In today's video, you'll learn how to generate and demodulate the HRP-UWB multi-millisecond signal using Keysight test software. Here's the agenda. In the first part, we'll introduce the concept of HRP-UWB MMS packet as defined in IEEE 802.15.4ab. In the second part, we'll dive into a live demo, which has three sections. First, we'll show you how to generate the signal using Signal Studio and 7610C. Next, we'll perform signal demodulation analysis using XApps software. Finally, we'll conclude with signal analysis using VSA software. Let's get started. If you are not familiar with UWB technology, check out this video link. It covers an overview of UWB technology and Keysight's UWB test solutions. IEEE 802.15.4ab was proposed in 2022 as amendment to the 802.15.4z standard, specially to enhance UWB communication protocols with a focus on improving ranging accuracy, data rates, range distance, and security. This amendment introduces new features and specifications such as multi-millisecond symbol MMS packets. Before the demo, let's quickly overview its physical layer structure. MMS UWB packets have two types of fragments: ranging sequence fragments, RSF, and ranging integrity fragments, RIF, optionally preceded by a HRP-UWB synchronization header. The packets can be RSF-only, RIF-only, or a mix of both. Each RSF contains the repetitive multi-millisecond symbols, and each RIF consists of a scramble timestamp sequence of the same length. The specification states that the time between the start of the last RSF and the first RIF should be 2 milliseconds. It also defines RSF marker for synchronization and RIF markers for verifying integrity and accuracy in UWB transmission. Next, let's dive into the demo. I'll show you how to generate this demo signal on channel 9 with a HRP-UWB synchronization header, followed by one ranging sequence fragment and one ranging integrity fragment. The instrument I'm using is M9015A VXT-PXI transceiver combining a vector signal generator and an analyzer. For this demo, I've directly connected the RF output part to the RF input part. The signal is generated and downloaded via LAN using Signal Studio and 7610C software. For signal demodulation analysis, you can use the XApps N9084EM0E HRP-UWB measurement app or the VSA 89601 BHTC option. First, let's walk through generating the demo signal step by step. I'm using software version 2024 Update 1.0. To connect the instrument, press the System button, then run System Configuration Wizard. Select VXT-PXI transceiver as a model type and press Next. Choose New, press Next, and enter your instrument's IP address. If you've added the instrument before, select its name from the list and press Next. Once connected, you'll see Connected in the bottom status bar. On the hardware page, you can view detailed information about the connected instrument. Navigate to the waveform setup page and set the physical specification to 802.15.4 HRP-UWB. On the HRP-UWB subpage, select HRP Enhanced Ranging Device HPRF for the HRP-UWB mode and set STS Packet Configuration to 3. This will enable MMS package settings. Turn on these settings to config RSF and RIF options. For the demo, turn on additional gaps to RSF and set channel number to channel 9. On the instrument page, set the frequency to the channel 9. Click Generate to generate the waveform, and then press Download to send it to the instrument for playback. Navigate to the waveform setup page. In the waveform menu, you can view the generated waveform as expected. Be sure to save your settings file so you can make changes later and easily perform the signal demodulation in the X-Apps. Now, let's move to X-Apps for signal demodulation analysis. To enter the HRP UWB measurement, select HRP UWB demode in the short-range communications mode and press OK. Instead of manually configuring the demodulation settings in X-Apps, you can record the setting file exported from Signal Studio. Go to the Config Frame page, and you will see all the demodulation settings automatically set for you. Remember to extend the search time for the synchronization. You should now see the HRP UWB MM signal synchronized and demodulated correctly. The pass indicator on the top bar shows this signal passes the Fira physical layer conformance test. X-Apps provides the RRC correlated trace, transmit power spectral density with limit line, baseband pulse response with limit line, and the time domain trace. Detailed physical layer results are available in the metrics table. To get measurement results for RSF and RF, click on the Window button here to add the results window and select MMS packet results. Additionally, you can view an overview of each field with pulse field indicator in the frame info table. The feature for HRP UWB MMS signal demodulation is now available in XA38. Give it a try. If you are a VSA user, you can demodulate the HRP UWB MMS signal using 89601 BHTC option. This feature is included in the 2024 Update 2. To demodulate the HRP UWB MMS signal, select the measurement type as IEEE A02.15.4 HRP UWB. In the demod properties, set the physical mode to Enhanced Range Device HPRF and the STS packet configuration mode to 3. Make sure the MMS packet checkbox is selected to view the RSF and the RF settings. For measurement results, VSA provides the RRC correlated trace, transmit power spectral density with limit line, baseband pulse response with limit line, and the time domain trace. In the Demod Symbols Errors table, you can see RSF on marker, RF on markers, and the average peak power of RSF and RF, along with pulse field results for each field in the frame info table. The markers table includes detailed delta value to limit line for the transmit power spectral density trace. Additionally, the VSA gives a pulse field indicator as a bottom bar to show whether the measurement passes the Fira physical layer conformance test. We are continuously following the latest UWB standards, so stay updated with us. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit our websites. Thank you for watching.